viewers, I want to welcome you to another edition on GovTV Daily Devotion. And today, by the grace of God, we are looking at lesson 8 that says environmental impact on the family. And underneath, we have three topics. The first one says, for the adult, behave your belief. And for the youth, say, wash what you wash. And for the intermediate, say, guide against world pollution. So before we go further, I just want us to have a word of prayer together. Our Heavenly Father, we bless your name this hour. As we want to go into your word, Holy Spirit, teach us by yourself in the name of Jesus. Let the word illuminate our life and give us a new joy in the name of Jesus. Thank you, our Heavenly Father. In Jesus' name we have prayed. Today, being 28th of October 2016, the topic we are just looking at is, don't learn the way of the world. Don't learn the way of the world. As a Christian, we find out that there are so many things that is happening in the world today. And the warning to us is we must not learn their own way. What happens to their way? We're going to look at it now. Let's look at what the Bible says in the book of Jeremiah, chapter 10, and verse 1 to 10. If you are there with me, take your Bible. Jeremiah, chapter 10. I take my reading from verse 1 down to 10. Reads, hear the word which the Lord speak. Get unto you, O house of Israel. Thus says the Lord, learn not the way of the heathen, and be not dismayed at the sign of heavens, for the heathens are dismayed at them. For the custom of the people are vain. For one cutteth a tree out of the forest, the work of the hands of the workman with the earth. They deck it with silver and with gold. They fasten it with nails and with hammers, that it move not. They are upright as the palm tree, but speak not. They must knit the bone, because they cannot go. Be not afraid of them, for they cannot do evil. Neither also is it them to do good. Verse says, for as much as there is none like unto thee, O Lord, thou art great, and thy name is great in might. Now let me quickly move to the last verses. But the Lord is a true God. He is a living God and an everlasting King. At his wrath, the earth shall tremble, and the nation shall not be able to abide his indignation. Beloved, God has really warned us through his prophet Jeremiah that we must not follow the line of the world. Do you know what the world do? They always make a graven image for themselves. They decorate it, they put many things on it, expensive things on it. And these are the things that cannot speak, that cannot talk, that cannot walk. Anything that cannot speak, that cannot talk, they can harm you. You must be able to have that assurance that this thing cannot walk, they cannot talk, then they can harm you. Then but the only one that can do all things is the living God. The one you and I are calling unto, the one that is Jehovah. Let's look at what we have for us here. It says, God through prophet Jeremiah was giving advice to the children of Israel that when they get to the promised land, they will see so many side attractions, foreign culture, lifestyle, strange religions, etc., etc. And that is exactly what is happening now in our environment. There are so many strange cultures in our environment today, all over the world, strange cultures. Strange things is happening. Things that are ungodly. But it is for you and I not to be distracted by them. But they must not learn the way of the Gentiles. Why? This is because worldly custom and fashion are futile and godless. They cannot add any value to one's life, but rather deplete one's life, make one an enemy of God, and eventually send the person to hell. I pray you will not go to hell in Jesus' name. Know that all that are in the world, the lust of the flesh, the lust of the eyes, and the pride of life, are not of the Father. Therefore, don't copy worldly system. Don't learn them. It's an instruction for us. Be godly and live life that is pleasing to God. And I'm charging you today that everything, the world will go and everything that's in the world. But if you hold on to God and do the right thing, just find out that you will enjoy and you have a good relationship with your Maker. It happens to be our Father. Then you will fear nothing. Then you will be, the confidence will be there for you. And I'm charging you this hour that you should please, in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, don't copy the world. Allow the world to go. Just follow righteousness and holiness in which you can see God. Our point of emphasis today is, do not conform to the system of this world. Do not conform to the system of this world. Our prayer point is, Lord, help me to love God and His way more than anything else. Lord, help me to love God. Help me. That is the prayer of all believers. Genuine believer, help me to love God so that my way can please you, God. And I pray this morning with you that your way will please God in Jesus' name. Shall we just bow down our head to pray? Our Heavenly Father, we thank you for your word that has come out to us this hour. We pray, Lord, that you will teach us and help us to love you the more, so that our way will please you every day of our lives in the name of Jesus. Thank you, our Heavenly Father. Blessed be your name, Lord. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. I appreciate you for watching this wonderful program this hour. By this time tomorrow, we are here on air giving you the word of God. For comment, contribution, and any question that you have, please look at the display on the screen. I'll get back to you. Thank you. God bless you.